Sky Bet EFL Q&A, Grimsby's Danny Collins spent 4 years as a joiner. When he limped out of Saturday's 2-1 win over Swindon with a grade 2 thigh strain, Grimsby defender Danny Collins was unwittingly giving himself Christmas off. Not that the former Chester, Sunderland, Stoke and Nottingham Forest defender, to name just his parent clubs, is happy about it. Even at the age of 38, he still wants to play in every game he can. That desire can partly be explained by his late start in the professional and 4 years spent as a joiner. The balanced Collins is the subject of this week's Sky Bet EFL Q&A and reflects on a career which has taken in trying to stop Arsenal duo Thierry Henry and Robin van Persie, as well as the more robust strikers he now encounters in League 2. He would love to play alongside Italy great Giorgio Chiellini and reveals a talent for cricket which came in handy this summer. Describe yourself on the pitch in 3 words. Vocal. A winner. Aggressive. Describe yourself off the pitch in 3 words. Joker. Family man. Inquisitive. I'm always learning. Best moment of your career so far? Probably making my full debut for Wales, a friendly at home to Hungary in February 2005. I came on not long into the second half at the Millennium Stadium. I think we won 2-0. My family were there and my missus came down with her family as well. Of course, there is a moment when you were waiting to come on when you think, this is it. You've got a few more nerves in the belly than if you were starting the game, but it was good to get out there and get a run out. It was nice to get the clean sheet, and I think I may have played the ball through for Craig Bellamy to score the second goal. Club-wise and individually, I got 2 back-to-back Player of the Year awards up at Sunderland at a time when it was quite tough as well, even though we stayed up in the Premier League. And I picked up the Northeast Football Writers Award at the same time, which was a nice achievement. The club won, coming from your own fans, is a big achievement as well. They're very fanatical about their football up there, so to get that praise was a nice reward. Who is the hardest opponent you have faced? I always find it difficult to answer this one. Strikers can be very different. You have aggressive battles with the big target lumps or you get the quick ones. But overall I would probably say Thierry Henry. I played against him 3 or 4 times and it was just everything about him, his movement, his pace, his touch. For me he's the best player who's played in the Premier League. My Premier League debut for Sunderland was at Highbury against Arsenal, in November 2005, which was a good learning experience. I think we lost 3-1 on the day and I came up against Robin van Persie and Henry up top that day. Henry scored 2 goals, van Persie the other. Straight in at the deep end. You gain experience by playing those players. It's completely different football playing in the top flight to what I'm playing in League 2 at the minute. I probably had 45 footballs in League 2 on a Saturday. In the Premier League where you're playing against the top teams, you probably wouldn't had more than 4 or 5 balls. It's all in and around your feet and the final third is where it switches on and you notice the quick 1-2s. The older you get and the more games you play, you adjust and you read the game differently. Young lads can be quick. But they may not know their way around the pitch. That only comes with experience and playing more games. Most embarrassing moment in football? Probably scoring an own goal against Forest Green this season. Grimsby lost 4-1 at home on the opening day in August. I've played more than 500 games and I don't think I've scored more than 3 or 4 goals in my career. It was a strange one. I went to play it back to Mukia, Grimsby keeper James McEwen, but he had come out to one side of the area to give me an angle. As I played it, I thought, oh no, he's not there. I could see it rolling and it was drifting towards the post. I thought, just hit the post, but it just crept inside the near post. I was hoping we could get back into the game, but we conceded a couple more after that. It was just a bad day overall. Luckily we went to Macclesfield the following week and won 2-0, so that put the own goal to bed. Even now, my mates have a bit of banter with me about it and a couple of the boys mention it at the training ground, but I've seen a few of those over the years on DVDs. You just try and move on, but it's something to look back on in the future. Which song gets you in the mood for a match? I quite like a couple of the older ones. I'm 38 now, so a few of the boys wouldn't know them. There's a couple of good old rock songs, Van Halen Jump, and Dire Straits' Walk of Life. Two good tunes. They're on playlists in my car. I've got a good 80s mix. Obviously, in this day and age, with a lot of the boys who take over the music systems, those tunes wouldn't get a look in. They wouldn't have heard of the artists, let alone the songs. We have a lot of rap and hip-hop in the changing room. I'm not too fussed on different genres, and I do like different stuff. As long as there's a bit of music on in the changing room before a game, that's what you want. What's your guilty food pleasure? At my age, you have to try and eat well to keep in good shape. I look after myself as much as I can, but on a Saturday night after a game, I usually pick up a Chinese on the way home. Dish of choice would be sweet and sour chicken Hong Kong style or chicken and beef satay. I would always have my Christmas Day dinner, although I'm not a massive fan of turkey, so I'd go for beef or lamb before turkey. There are 8 of us this year at the mother-in-law's. I'll be on chef duties on Christmas Day, and I won't have to rush off because I've got a grade 2 thigh strain at the minute, so I'll be out a few weeks. I'd much rather be out on the pitch playing on Boxing Day than sitting it out, though. Which player in history would you like to play alongside, and why? Looking back, you'd say Bobby Moore because he was one of the top center halves in the world. I watched the BBC program on him the other week. In the modern day, I'd probably go for either Giorgio Chiellini at Juventus or Diego Godin at Atletico Madrid. One of those two. Proper defenders. The only problem I'd have playing alongside Chiellini is that we're both left-footed, so one of us would have to shift over to the right side. I think I'm younger than him, so that would be me. He'd pull rank on me, wouldn't he? Italians have been renowned for their defending over the years. They take pride in their clean sheets, and they've also been renowned for one or two naughty incidents in trying to get the better of the opposition, so I could learn it from him. Which famous manager would you have loved to play for, and why? I know it's modern day, but I'd probably go for Pep Guardiola. I like the style he wants, and he seems to give his lads the confidence to go out and play. I watched the series on Man City the other week, and he looks good in the changing room and the training ground. He just seems to pour confidence into their boys and into what he wants them to do. I like everything that I've seen of him so far. He could make me better, of course he could. Whatever age you are. I'm 38 now, and I'm still learning, still improving, and looking to do the best I can. Whether it's the league, the Champions League, or the Carabao Cup, he wants to go out there and win. He just wants the best for his players and for Man City. What would you be if you weren't a footballer? I was actually a joiner up until I was 20. I was at Chester's Centre of Excellence as a kid up until 15 or 16. I wasn't enjoying it, so I went playing local football in the Welsh leagues, and I didn't turn pro again until 20 when Chester were in the Conference, now National League. So when I left school at 16, I went to do joinery on an apprenticeship. I was a wood machinist in a factory making doors, windows, and stairs. When Chester came and said they wanted to take me on full-time, they were in the Conference. I thought my chance of becoming a pro footballer had probably gone, so I was delighted, and I had to knock the joinery on the head. I was playing centre midfield at the time, and then Mark Wright, the former England defender who was the Chester manager, moved me into the back four. He said, "I like the look of you at centre half," and that was it. I became a centre half from then on. Tell us a secret that fans won't know. I used to play cricket at a decent standard. I got Wales minor counties caps as a left-arm spinner who went into bat at number 6 or 7. I could do a bit of both, but I was mainly a bowler. Grimsby fans might know that because this pre-season Grimsby Town Football Club played Grimsby Town Cricket Club in a 20-over match, a bit of a barbecue day. We batted first, I went in at number 3 and got 80 not out. We beat them as well, which was quite funny. We bowled them out. I got 2 or 3 wickets, so it was a good night. I think they struggled in their fixtures after that. Sky Bet are the proud title sponsors of the EFL. For a wide range of markets and price boosts across EFL matches, visit skybet.com.